Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Planet Coaster. We'll be working on something a little different than normal today. I want to work on something large scale and across multiple episodes. So the build series has been doing really well lately, and we have been constructing different themes, different coaster stations for you guys to use on the Steam Workshop. And now I think at this point, what I want to do is change it up a little bit, and instead of doing just a one evening type of build that's just, you know, within 3 or 4 hours, I'm gonna go ahead and make a multi-part series here, trying to recreate something from a cartoon. Now the cartoon is going to be The Legend of Korra. I hope to make the whole Air Temple Island around Republic City, and hopefully you guys will enjoy the overall build process. This episode, simply what we're going to be doing is working on the first foundation of the first structure. It's a little complicated. It took a little bit of time to do this. Even digging out this ditch here, I had to lower the ground in the whole park, because eventually what I want to do is make it look like there is an island kind of inset and laid into here. And the best way to do that is start at zero, and then I can build up the mountain as I see fit that the island is kind of made of. And then from there, we can fill in the water, other details, and make it kind of blend into the natural scenery of the sandbox that we are using right now. So, using the smooth concrete, because it is colorable, and the first structure that we're going to be working on over the next couple episodes is the main kind of, it's almost like a pagoda. It's a tall, about 7 stories when you get to the tower part, but this is just going to be the foundation and base structure. Now this is how I kind of start all my builds. I kind of want to get a scale for things, and that's also why we haven't built the whole island yet. I'm going to be basing the island size and other building scales off this main structure itself, as it's kind of the largest structure but also kind of the easiest to measure off of. Here, just making sure the height is going to be okay with the park height limit. You know, gotta make sure you're within dimensions before you get a little too out of control, because I want this island to be pretty tall as well. And in doing so, that will hopefully portray fairly accurately what we're going for. Hopefully, in the speed build of just digging out this hole, I'll kind of overlay what we are working on. At least based off on. And there's not many good shots of just the overall island itself. It looks like there's a little bit more fan art kind of reference photos on Google that I can reference. So that's kind of my main reference source for this build so far. And it's fine to kind of wing it a little bit, you know? We don't have to get it exactly 100% correct. As long as it looks like it and is recognizable, I think this is going to be a successful build overall. Now, it is going to be a multi-building structure just because it has some odd shapes and angles. The main foundation of the pagoda-like element is supported by this very wide base, and it has some nice interesting shapes to it. It's almost like a slight diamond shape that kind of tapers off near the top and rounds itself, but it is holding a 6-sided spire, and that's kind of interesting. A 6-sided kind of object here is not really the easiest shape to make in Planet Coaster, because obviously we can't align a grid to a couple of the sides. I'm going to align the first grid off of this, and I'm actually not measuring probably the correct angles to get this thing perfectly symmetrical. It's really heavily guesswork at this point, and that's kind of just how I like to work when it comes to Planet Coaster. Winging it to me is kind of a more free experience, because if I sat there and tried to measure everything out exactly, it would almost be a little too taxing. Though, it would save you guys a whole bunch of time in the long run. But I'm going to be starting out making some loose estimates as to how I want this base to perform. And it does have angled slopes. So if you guys think back to the Cathedral of Light, that's kind of the mindset that I am in here. And luckily, we did get plenty of practice using timber frames to align and make our rough skeleton so that we can go in and easily fill that in with the actual stonework that's going to be making up the spire. And we're only going to go ahead and go up 2 levels of the spire, and that's going to bring us to basically the top of the front end. And there are about 7 more floors to go after this whole foundation is constructed. And it's going to be maybe an episode or 2 until this is fully completed. There's some details in terms of roofing and, of course, some more fancier elements. This is kind of the main temple structure as far as I'm aware. The air temples and things always were made up of these very tall cylinder type shapes. Now, luckily, the one by Republic City is a little different. It's a little bit more of a traditional plaza-based shrine that you might see in either China or Japan. You know, it's not really a whole bunch of cylinders crammed together to make a different shape. It is a whole bunch of separate buildings connected across the island. And it's going to be hopefully a really cool build. It's one of those things where it's going to be a day at a time. If you guys want, I can actually delay each episode because usually, you know, I do shoot for an upload a day. And this is going to be a very long build process. And really, not a whole lot might get done per episode just due to how complicated some of these shapes are. As you can see, just making the large base here is taking some time and trying to figure out the final measurements so there's not, you know, any weird clipping going on. And this stuff I could do, you know, and take 2 days after work to complete these. That way we have about eight or so hours of footage to go through in a speed build. And it might look better for an episode, but hey, if you guys want an episode every day, that's fine. You know, we can do that. That's only 4 or so hours a night, and it's totally doable in my schedule, and that's kind of the base schedule as is right now. You might be wondering also where our sci-fi park is. Now the sci-fi park, I have to be honest, I'm a little burned out on it still. You know, I thought giving it a rest over the holidays was going to be good and I could come back and finish that thing up. But to be honest, I just don't feel like working on that thing right now. I'm not really feeling the inspired juices to go ahead and push forward on it. And it becomes a little bit of a chore at a certain point when you're working on something like that. So, you know, the channel is supposed to be kind of fun, and if you guys can hear it in my voice when I'm either stressed about trying to make something every you know, day, even if it's something that I don't enjoy, obviously it's going to show through. So, you know, to prevent that and to make these, you know, inspiring builds, I would much rather work on something that, you know, I'd rather work on. It's tough to explain, I guess, my feelings personally on this, but forgive me, I'm doing, I guess, the best I can. But we have, you know, a simple step-like effect going up here. We will be adding a little bit of roofing towards the end of the speed build. I will have to be making some custom roof tiles, you know, very similar to what Silverette does or something like that, or, well, I guess most people do when they are doing a very detailed oriented build. You'll notice that most of my builds so far are actually a little less detailed than a lot of people's, and that's just simply because it is a little bit of a time sink at a certain point and a level of detail that I don't usually go into. But I think for this one, because I do like Legend of Korra, though I do prefer Last Airbender, it is something that I want to try and capture to its fullest. So we're going to be going into some heavy detailing later on in the series, and hopefully you guys can learn a thing or two. But, you know, doing this framework and copying it around to make the main spire, we've gone over how to do this before in many episodes. It's simply, you know, building a repeatable shape that you can copy off a central axis around, and hopefully that will give you a completed look. Now, you do have to try and line up these corners rather nicely, or else it won't copy quite correctly. We also will get some additional wall elements and some windows off the main sections. We might even get to copy that around a little bit to the other flat sides. Now, I did want to try and cheat also, potentially use the octagonal walls, but it just didn't look quite right to the rest of the building because of the material difference, but then also the angular difference wasn't going to line up. So what we're going to end up doing is simply making our own custom shape all the way up through the spire, and that's fairly normal for something custom like this. The courtyard, you know, around the base just has a nice simple sealed flat wall. At least that's what I can tell from the reference images. I will be finding more as the build continues. And then at this point, we'll just go ahead and make our first little custom roof. Now, I am probably not the best when it comes to these little details. Now, I think that's just simply because it's not something that I generally try to capture. But hopefully as the series continues, we'll get a little bit better at these type of things. Trying to get, you know, a little bit of a curve. It's very common to have Chinese roofing to have these elements, and then also your cross beams, and you can offset them to create a little bit of a layering effect with the shadows. Currently, they are a little purple looking. The reference image calls for a little bit more of a normal blue, or maybe even a sky blue color. So we'll end up changing that near the end. But, you know, as long as the look and shape is roughly correct, that's what we're looking for currently. I'm sure we'll go over many passes as the series goes on. So this is pretty much as far as I get tonight. If you guys are interested in seeing what it looks like in real time, not much to show off, but we can go ahead and take a look at that here in a second. You can see testing some of the roof elements, noticing it was a different color though, and then recoloring it. It's kind of a color balance issue, I think, at this moment. Looks weird with all the white around it. Yeah, so let's go see what you guys think. Okay, so this is currently where we are at in the build so far. Now, there's going to be a lot of elements, you know, trying to butt up against the main foundation here, and that's going to hopefully look like it's attached a little bit better to the ground. Currently, you know, it's just sitting on top here, and we will be changing things as the scale kind of gets established and the total aesthetic goes forward. But I do like to show you guys kind of points throughout the build process instead of just going straight to kind of a finished state, because I hope, you know, seeing things in chunks helps you guys learn the tools of the game, and then also show you guys that, you know, it's not too difficult to do things like this. It's really just how much time you want to try and get into it, and so you can get these kind of custom shapes and objects done. Now, luckily, you know, testing out the roof, and at least the base shape of the roof, I might go in and make these look a little bit more detailed than they already are. And, you know, when you're doing modular pieces like this roof and things, you want to keep an eye on how it's going to repeat through. As you can see here, we have two lines, kind of a larger gap, and then two lines again. This is not quite evenly spaced, though luckily, you know, we're not having any really weird tiling issues. But it's just something to keep in mind when you are making modular pieces. You want to, you know, think about how they are lining up and everything. And all this stuff can be changed. We're still early enough where all of this can easily be removed and worked on. But you can see it's going to be a really tall building for sure. And it's going to hopefully take up a huge amount of area. So if we just zoom out here, you can see how large it is just compared to the park. I guess the general size itself, this is even the upgraded park scale. And there's kind of the main path coming in. So it's probably going to be maybe a little bit bigger than the Cathedral of Light. Definitely in terms of parts. We're already at 3,200 parts, and shoot, maybe even more, 3,600. And that's just all the, you know, custom kind of skinning we have to do to get these interesting slopes. Now, luckily, as we get higher up, the custom skinning becomes a little less and less, but the roof tiles themselves are going to provide a large amount of part count. And when you get crazy with the part count and trying to go after detail like we were about to do, it can definitely affect the FPS in the game. So that's something I'll have to be watching throughout, but hopefully we can take this thing as far as we can. A little bit of an angle, weird angle there. This is what happens when you eyeball it. Things might not line up quite exactly right. But other than that, this is, you know, currently the inside. You can see the scaffolding at work and everything like that. And hopefully you guys have learned one thing this episode. You know, when it comes to skinning, possibly just working on the foundational shapes and how to align multiple buildings to get the overall shape you're looking for. So if you guys are excited for what we will be working on next here on this channel, go ahead and subscribe and leave a like down below. Leave a comment on if you guys, you know, maybe what your favorite Avatar, Last Airbender or Korra character is. And I will see you guys in the next episode.